Hello people, today we are going to teach you a very important lesson which is related to some of the phrasal verbs in English. We are going to teach you some English phrasal verbs. This is a very nice lesson, my dear friend. I tell you the truth, we are going to enjoy this lesson very better. It's a very wonderful lesson. Let's start. You are going to speak English or to study English with Teacher Jasper. Ujie kuburi kumwe na Teacher Jasper, as usual, nkibisanzwe. Teacher Jasper is going to direct you to the lesson. Mwerekeje rero ku isomo, phrasal verbs. Phrasal verbs. Abo bushize cyangwa se abize amasomo y'ubushize, muziko phrasal verb ariki? A phrasal verb, it's a verb plus a preposition. A verb plus a preposition. Nijie ufite verb ukongera preposition. Rimwe na rimwe ugasanga niyo verb ihinduye meaning yari ifite. Twarabibonye ubushize. Ubu tugiye kubaha ingero zitandukanye kuri phrasal verbs. Ikindi noneho gikomeye cyane. Twabateguriye program nziza yo kujya tubigisha nyuma y'isomo tukabaha icyo twakwita nka quote cyangwa se a saying, imvugo runaka cyangwa se quote, imvugo yavuzwe n'umuhanga runaka. Ubwo rero ntimukajye mucikwa. Nyuma y'iri somo turabagezaho imvugo nziza cyane mu by'ukuri twabateguriye mu cyongereza y'icyongereza kugira ngo ujye uyikoresha mu buzima busanzwe bwa buri munsi mu gihe uri kuvuga ururimi rw'icyongereza. Thank you very much. We are going to start from the phrasal verb which is wake up. To wake up. Wake up and get up. We are going to see the difference between wake up and get up. To wake up tuvuga ko ari ugukanguka, icyo gihe ni ugukanguka. When you are opening your eyes in the morning, icyo gihe you are waking up or you wake up. We say that I wake up. To wake up, wake up, ni ugukanguka. Kuba amaso yarahumye cyangwa asinziriye cyangwa se afunze, wagira utya, you wake up now. For example, here you can say, I wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning. I wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Wake up. Wake up. I wake up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Bishatse kuvuga ngo nkanguka saa 12 z'igitondo. But let's see or let's have a look at get up. We are going to see the difference between wake up and get up. This is another phrasal verb which is get up. Many people used to confuse these two phrasal verbs. Abantu benshi bakonfuzinga izi phrasal verbs ebyiri. Get up, no, ni ukubyuka. Kuva ku gitanda ugiye, that you are getting up that time. That is to get up. Get up, wake up. Wake up, gukanguka, gutangira kubona, then get up, kubyuka. For example, here you can say, I get up at 6:10. I wake up at 6, but I get up at 6:10 after praying, after thinking about my day. Nyuma yo gutekereza ku munsi wanje, I get up at 6:10 in the morning. This means that uyu akangutse. Uyu nguye akangutse saa 12 ariko yabyutse saa 12 n'iminota 10 cyangwa nkangutse saa 12 ariko ngiye gusenga iminota 5 no gutekereza ku munsi wanje. I'm going to think about my day. I'm going to think about what I'm going to do during the day. Just before you get up, try to think about your day. That is to get up. Turn, to turn off or to switch off. Turn off, switch off. Especially electronic devices. Cyane cyane ibintu nk'amatelefone, televiziyo, radio, dukoresha turn off or switch off. For example, here I can say, I always turn off my lamp when it's time to bed. I always turn off my lamp when it's time to bed. Buri gihe itara ryanjye ndarizimya iyo hageze igihe cyo kuryama cyangwa se iyo ngiye kuryama. I always turn off my lamp when it's time to bed. Good. Try to understand me very well. We have got We have first of all got to wake up, get up, turn off. Now we are going to see turn on. To turn on is like to switch on. No, kwatsa. Kwatsa. For example, I can say, she always turns on her lamps at evening hours. At yatsa matara ye, mumasaha yumugoro. Kuko ni mugoro ba murabizi kwa riho amatara agomba kuba yak. She always turns on her lamps at evening hours. Mumasaha yumugoroba igihe cyose yatsa matara amatarai. Good. That is the fourth. This is the fourth phrasal verb. Niyakani inji. Gatan. Five. To take off or to put off. Nukwambura. Take off or put off. Kuba wambuye ibyo wari wambaye. Cyangwa se wambuye inkweto wari wambaye. You are taking off your shoes. Or you are putting off your clothes. Here you can say take off or put off. But most of the time people used to say take off. To take off. This one is somehow archaic. Put off bisanaho ni mvuga isanaho itakigezweho cyane iri archaic. It's an archaic English language. Then here we say take off or put off. Good. For example, I can say when I go to bed, I take off my clothes. Yonjiye kuryama nkuramo imyenda yanjye. I take off my clothes and I wear my pajamas, or I wear night dress. If you are a girl or a woman, ushobora kwambara a night dress or mugaba kambara pajamas. Good. Pajamas. Good. When I go to bed, I take off my clothes. Yongiye kuryama nkuramo imyenda yanjye. Aka kantu kagafata. Example sentence ukayifata ukajyikoresha. Good. Number 6 here is to stand out. Stand out ni kwigaragaza, kwibonekeza, kuba ushaka ko bakubona. You are standing out. To stand out. For example, you may say, when she is in the public, she used to stand out. Yari murimuru, hamerguabano, she stands out. Ari garagaza. To stand out, nukui garagaza wanu wakakubona. Kutihisha, kuburi wa munu, wambonyu, urikuri, wambonyu jechose. That's, you are standing out that time. Yeah, to stand out. For example, you can say, she likes to stand out when she is in public. Yeah, as I've said, she likes to stand out when she is in public. Akunda kwigaragaza, akunda ko bamubona mu gihe ari hehe, ari mu ruhame, cyangwa se ari mu bantu benshi. She likes to stand out when she is in public. Paul or Peter likes to stand out when he is in interview. Yo Peter ari muri interview yakazi. When Peter is in job interview, he likes to stand out. Akunda kuba ari we babona gusa. Akunda kushaka ko ari we babona gusa ko yagerageje yakoze iyo bwaba. That is to stand out. Then the last one of today is to pop into. To pop into no kugerageza kwinyabya hantu. Kujya hantu kwirasa hantu ariko ntuhatinde. You are popping into. That is a phrasal verb which is very important. For example, you can say, oh, I'm very hungry today. Let me pop into that restaurant before I go to the hospital. Rekambanze ndashonje, rekambanze nje muri restaurant gato, ninyabyeyo, kwinyabya, kwikoza ahantu by'akanya gato gahita ukomeza. That is to pop into. You should know that because sometimes you need to use this kind of phrasal verb in your English day life situation. That's why here, when you are popping into, you are going somewhere in a very short time, then you are returning back and you are continuing your journey. That time you are popping into. For example, I can say, tomorrow I will pop into the market before I go to church. Tomorrow I will pop into the market before I go to church. This means that church, we say church, we don't say church. Not church, say church, to church. Good. Tomorrow I will pop into the restaurant or into the market before I go to church. Ejo, tomorrow I will pop into the market. Ejo nzabanza kwinyuza ku isoko mbere yuko njya gusenga. To pop into kwinyuza ahantu runaka cyangwa se guca ahantu runaka for a very short time. Mumuno tumwe ukaburagarutse cyangwa ibiri. You are popping that time to pop into. You are popping into that place to pop into somewhere good. Then now we are going to give you the saying of today. A saying. Imvugo y'uyu munsi ni iyihe rero. A saying of today. Mu cyongereza turavuga ngo never stop learning because life never stops teaching. That is a quote of today, or a saying. That is a saying, because no one just that I know who said that. Nta muntu nzi wabivuze, niyo mpamvu ari saying, ni imvugo. Never stop learning because life never stops teaching. What does it mean? Ntugahagarike kwiga kubera ko isi itagihagarara kwigisha. Never stop learning because life never stops teaching. Uzabivuga mu gihe umuntu ubona ari gukina n'ubuzima. Life is the best teacher. Ubuzima ni ryo shuri cyangwa se niwe mwarimu wa mbere. That's why you should never stop learning. Kugira ngo uhangane n'ubuzima, ntabwo ugomba kurekeraho kugira gute kwiga kugira ngo uhangane nabo. Never stop learning because life never stops teaching. Thank you very much. Ariko wumve ko every day, every time, igihe cyose twatanze isomo, turajya tubahereza quote cyangwa se imvugo runaka mu cyongereza, akantu runaka utahanye nyuma y'isomo umaze kwiga. Ibyo bizagufasha cyane. I am Teacher Jasper. We are together for the next time. Bye bye.